Good night, everyone. Today we want to talk about the soccer parents. You know what is the soccer parent for us as a coaches? They are one of the most important person in this process for us, the soccer parents. In this process where we are building more than players, person for the future. And then it is really important that you are with us. But if you know, the parents usually make mistakes. There are five big mistakes. Usually we find this. We like when the parents enjoy to watch, to see the player, your children play. That's really nice for us as a coaches too, because that is helpful for the relationship, for the club, for the kids. But sometimes we find this situation. Yeah? This situation. What happened? We need the parents in another behavior, in another position, when they go to see the players play. You go to enjoy. Yeah, you go to enjoy. And then sometimes we find this kind of parents, but this is normal. Why? Because the parents sometimes think that they are doing well. They are in the right way. Look, five mistakes for the soccer parents make with the players. The first mistake that they don't encourage the players to make mistakes. You don't permit that your kids make mistakes. That is big mistakes. Why? Because the coaches like that the kid made mistakes. That's the only way that they can learn. But you force them, demand them, the excellent, but no. Usually, they make mistakes. That is a good moment to learn from the players, yeah? And then you can talk with them about this mistake. But you have to choose the place, the moment to talk with them about this mistake. The second mistake is they find people that allow them to fight. You find that don't belong to you. For example, look, we have this one situation. That is amazing. That's not what you going to find with the ref. I don't know what is the situation. You don't need that. That's not your fight. You go to watch your kid play. That's the situation. That's against the other players. The opponent team, and then you go to fight with them. Why? That's not the objective when you go to watch or to see your kids play. That's the only reason that you go to the field. You don't need to fight. Look, that's behaviors. That's amazing. The other situation is that you want to coach. You want to coach. Yeah, you become coach. You become coach. Then the other. They don't engage their players in the development process. We need that the players, the commitment that they create here, that they get here, had to be deep. Because we need the players, we demand the players here, a lot of things. The parents have to understand the situation. It's not only bring the parent, the kids, leave the kids, and then it's finished. No, we need that the kids be involved In the process, in the whole process. The other, the coach and cheer for the wrong thing on the game day. And then we go to this picture, this. Why you have to coach your kid? When you look, you are here, the coach is on the field. Coach your kid. And then why you coach? That's the question. Then you don't need to coach. Maybe you are the support for your team, for your kid, for your children. But the coach is the coach. The decision of the coach are the decision of the coach. He knows exactly what happened when he took out. One player, when he takes out one player and put him on the bench, he knows exactly what happened with the kid. What happened in this moment, that's the decision. The other is they analyze the game with the players afterward. Yeah? You take the bad moment to analyze the game. Why? Because you are finished. The game was finished. Maybe they lost. And when you go home, you start to analyze the game. The kids don't like it. In one interview, in one survival, the kids don't like that the parents talk with them after the game. That's the situation. Then we have to keep in mind, that's the fact. We offer you options. Best advice for soccer parents. We have the first, keep quiet on the ride home. Don't talk about soccer. Talk about another thing, but don't talk about soccer. Why? Because sometimes the kid is stressed. Yeah, if he lost, they don't need that you repeat the same situation. They know what they do. Bad or well, and then you don't need to repeat. They need that you listen, you hear them, you talking. If they ask you, you can do. But the rest, close your mouth and go home. Choose the moment to confront their child about a play. No, prefer don't do it after the game. Or in the game. Don't do it. Invite it to eat something and then you can do it. Player, look, do not need adults to question the action of the other player, or the goal, decision concerning strategy or playing time. They know. But why Mikai played more than the other? Why he can score? Why you not score? Why you didn't score? No, they don't need that. Please, don't do it. The other, enjoy and let them play and enjoy. Enjoy your song and let them play and enjoy. The other, the only exception to the above right home rule is when you chill, engage, in behavior that you would not accept at home. Maybe he hit somebody for the back, he made a big mistake, he gets red card, and then you need to stop this behavior. That's the only moment when you can break the rule. Avoid coaching from the sideline while watching your child's game. Enjoy. Why? That's advice. Why? Because you are really important for us. We need you. But the kids need one support. Confidence, understanding, and one person forever when they need to talk with you, you are next to them to talk. That's it. Okay.